Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I am coming at you with my entire Chanel handbag collection. I have gotten a lot of requests to do my entire handbag collection, but instead I decided to break it into two parts. So part one would be my entire Chanel handbags and part two would be the rest of the designer handbags that I have in my collection. So let's get started. I'm going to start off with the first bag that I added to my collection and then work my way up to the newest one that I added. So the first handbag that I ever bought myself, and in fact, all the handbags that I'm going to show you today are purchased by myself. So this one is called the GST Grand Shopping Tote. Chanel no longer makes this. It's so sad. It is such a stunning bag and it has held up so well over the years. I bought it mainly to use it for work and that is what I did. And if you'll see, it has held up so well. The structure of the bag, the bottom of the bag, and yeah, this is the only larger size handbag that I have from Chanel. So mine is in this caviar leather with the silver hardware. So that's the first handbag. After I got the tote, I wanted to add the medium large, the classic flap. I got myself this one. Now, when I went to the store, I did not have a particular color in mind, and they had this one kind of on the shelf. I saw it, fell in love. She came home with me. So this one, I think the color is called royal blue or deep blue. It's a stunning, vibrant blue. I have not seen Chanel produce this color ever since I bought it until now. So right now, Chanel kind of brought this color back in so many different handbags, like in classic flaps, Coco handle, boy bag. I think I saw it in Chanel 19 too. So if you happen to like this color, this is the time for you to grab it. Mine is in this lovely lambskin with champagne gold hardware. I love this handbag. The only thing is I am not carrying this bag so much these days. Yeah, but who knows. So this was my second piece from Chanel. After this, I actually added, before I added this, I actually added a jumbo to my collection, which is also a classic flap, but in a bigger size, which is the jumbo size. It was in beige clear caviar leather with gold hardware. I no longer have it in my collection, but I will be sure to pop a picture. I don't know why I got the jumbo, but you know, I felt like I had the tote, I had the medium large size, so I wanted to have a little bit of a variety, so I went for the jumbo. Yeah, I never found myself using that bag. I literally had to force myself to use that bag. It was a stunning bag. It was just the size. I wish I would have gotten it in the medium large size, but anyways, now it's gone to a different home. So after that bag, I actually bought this one. This is also a medium large double flap, black with gold. You can tell that I was on a kick for medium large bags, and thank God I got a few of them, because looking at the prices now, I feel that I did, or I made the right choice. So that's that. This one is in caviar. After this, after I had my totes, I had my classic flaps, I wanted to venture out and get something slightly edgy, slightly different, but still stay within the classic line. So I got myself the boy bag. Now, boy bag is certainly a classic black bag, but it is slightly kind of different. It's edgy. I loved all the elements of the bag. Mine is in the lambskin, where it's in this beautiful red color with brushed gold hardware, and I love it. Now, the red color of this one is a little bit more kind of towards the orange family. But yeah, it's a beautiful, beautiful red, and I think it pairs very well with the gold. I love this handbag, and even though it's in lambskin, it has held up like really, really well. I do have a dedicated video on this bag, so just in case if you're interested, I will be sure to link it. You can check that out after you watch this video. So this bag, I bought it in 2015, and that was kind of the phase wherein I kind of took a pause from Chanel. I felt like I had pretty much all the pieces that I desired at that time. And I was never into the mini or the walk. I didn't feel like they served any purpose, especially the walk. I mean, I wish I would have gotten a mini flap, at least at the time, looking at the prices now. But yeah, I did not add any mini flap or any walk to my collection, and I still don't have a walk in my collection. So going back, this was the last handbag that I bought from Chanel, and that was in 2015. I took a pause until 2020, I think, early 2020. So it was pretty much like a 5 years break from Chanel. That's a long time, right? So after 5 years, I actually saw, I think I saw a video on the Coco handle, and she was reviewing a medium size Coco handle. I loved that bag. I went to the store to check out this line, and I found out that it comes in a lot of different colors and sizes. So I went with the mini. The way this bag got sourced was I was very particular about the color and also the chevron. So I know that this bag comes in the quilted, and I had all my bags in quilted. So when I saw the chevron, I was like, you know what? I want the chevron in this color combination. And my SA, she's so sweet. When she checked in the system, she was like, you know what? There's just one left in the entire country. Let me see if I can source it for you. And she did it. This bag came all the way from Las Vegas, and yeah, I could not be more happy. So this is the Coco handle. It also has the strap. So yeah, mine one has like a fabric interior. I know that these days Coco handles, they have like a leather interior, but this one has the fabric interior. So this is my mini Coco handle, and I wanted it in this particular color just because I felt like I had that gap, and this one filled that gap for the medium large beige clair. But the beige color of this one, I like it better than the jumbo that I had. So this was it. After I got the Coco handle in 2020, this kind of reignited my love for Chanel. And in 2021, I got myself the Chanel 19. I did an unboxing on my channel. I have a review of this bag on my channel. So this is again in lambskin, with mixed metal, size small, color is ivory. So that is the Chanel 19. And soon after, actually, I got the Chanel 19, I got myself the mini. The mini rectangular. This one is from the Pearl Crush line. This is in the color white with brushed gold hardware, lambskin. But these two bags, if you compare side by side, they are quite different in color also, but you know, the usage of these bags are quite different. And after I added this, the last piece that I have from Chanel, or the last piece that I added to my collection, is also a white bag. Oh my God, I know, I am crazy. So this one is the double flap in the small size, white, champagne gold, and and it's in caviar. So this one is slightly different. I mean, not different, it's the same. It's just that the size is different. This one is the medium large and this one is the small. So this kind of concludes my bag collection from Chanel. I am very happy with all the pieces that I have. And yeah, that is kind of my collection. Let me know which one was your favorite from this handbag, and if you feel that I am kind of missing a particular style that I should look into from Chanel. That is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you made it this far, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and I will see you in my next one. Bye now.